I remember very famous quote that is inspired by nature, sustained by farmer. Yes, you are right. We are going to learn about the topic agriculture. The term agriculture is derived from Latin word that is agar and culture. Agar means land or field, while cultura means cultivation. Agriculture is defined as the art, the science, and the business of producing crops and the livestock for economic purposes. As an art, it embraces knowledge of the way to perform the operations of the farm in a skillful manner. As a science, it utilizes all modern technologies developed on scientific principles such as crop improvements, breedings, crop productions, crop protection, economics, etc. While as a business, aims to maximum net returns through the management of land, labor, waste, and capital, employing the knowledge of various science for production of food, feed, fiber, and fuel. Let us try to understand the term agriculture.
What fuel does our body require to carry out its day-to-day functions? Food? That's right. Where do we get the food from? The cereals, pulses, and vegetables on our plate come from somewhere, don't they? Where do you think they come from? Did you just say the earth? Yes, they do grow on earth, but who grows them for us? The farmers, that's right. We also get our food from animals. These animals are reared and taken care of by humans. This food then fuels our body to carry out all its processes. Can you name a few processes of the body that need energy? Digestion, excretion, respiration are a few common processes. Without food, our body wouldn't be able to function at all. But can't every human produce his or her own food? Do you think this is a feasible option? Imagine growing your food every day. I assure you this wouldn't be an easy job to do, and that is why we need our farmer friends. They produce food for the entire country. And with the growing population, food needs to be produced on a large scale. What do we mean by producing food? Are planting seeds and breeding of animals the only events in food production? Of course not. A lot of effort goes into the process of food production. One of the things this process includes is regular production of food. Secondly, proper management of the resources produced. And lastly, fair distribution among the people. But how did this idea of food production come into existence? What do we call production of plants in a specific area of land? Agriculture. You guessed it right. But how did man get this idea of agriculture? Man was nomadic for many years. Survival was mainly dependent on fruits, roots, and hunting of animals for food. Eventually, man learned the culture of cultivation. Man learned agriculture by observing nature. So what is the most important part among all the components in agriculture? Of course, the crops. But what exactly do we mean by crops? When seeds of a plant are grown on a large scale, we call it a crop. Crops of wheat, rice, or sugarcane can be grown at a time on a piece of land. Crops can be of cereals, vegetables, or pulses, but each crop needs a specific type of weather. Crops are therefore classified based on the season they are grown in. Can you guess which two types of crops are grown in India? Let me help you with that. The two major crop seasons in India are the season of the Kharif crops and that of the Rabi crops. What is the difference between the two? The former are sown in the rainy season, while the latter are sown in the winter season. Rainy season in India spans from June to September. Crops grown in this period are paddy, maize, soybean, which require moisture and a large quantity of water. When does India have winter? Winter months in India begin with the month of November, extending till the month of February. Which crops do you think are best suited in this climate? Take a guess. Yes, wheat, mustard and grams are a few of the winter crops. So can we say that paddy, maize and soybean are kharif crops? Yes. And similarly, we can say that wheat, mustard and grams are rabi crops. What is grown in the summer months then? Well, summer months usually do not see a lot of cultivation. But some vegetables and pulses can be grown in the summer with the help of irrigation. This is all about the types of crop seasons in India. What about the process of agriculture? What are the agricultural practices undertaken by farmers? We will learn about these in our next lesson.
Check your knowledge regarding the topic, how much you understand by giving answers to the given questions. I hope you understand the topic. We again meet with new topic. Till then, stay at home, be safe, be happy. Your tutor, Komal Meshram.